Hello everyone and welcome to Telecreations. In this video I'm going to be looking at what is Everything Blue. This is a standard release, Blu-ray in particular. I'm going to show off my favourite one. I have a few of their releases, and if you want to guess, they are all Edgar Wright films. I have Shaun of the Dead, the standard slipcover version. I have the lenticular of Hot Fuzz. I have the standard release slipcover of The World's End. Plus, I have the, 850-unit version of Shaun of the Dead coming in the mail. So, this is my one that I want to demonstrate. This is Scott Pilgrim vs. the World, one of my favourite films. This is limited to 1,000 units, number 202, as you can see on the base there. This is a particularly interesting design compared to most of theirs. It's a slight bit bulkier, but it comes with its slipcover, which has some nice glossy effects to it, and some effects on the outside, emboss, deboss, all that jazz. Really fun stuff overall, and a beautiful coloration. Plus, I think what is arguably a standard release steelbook. So they come with steelbooks. Oh, this one doesn't actually come with a cut. Okay, I guess I will have to show off a second edition as well. This is the steelbook that it comes with. Comes with stuff on the inside, mostly being, in this case, a pick, guitar pick with the actual logo of the film on it, which you can't really see because it's not choosing the focus, which is fine, and what looks like on the inside, and a little tag that came from the actual thing, just saying limited edition version and whatever. So that's a really fun little thing that they've got. It did come with... it just came with a regular slip on the back. Most Everything Blues, which I will show off a different version, because this is just the slipcover Scott Pilgrim. We have Hot Fuzz. Yeah, Hot Fuzz seems like a worthwhile show off. Okay, this is what their lenticulars come with. Most of their editions come in twofold. You have the big box, which I'll show an image here of the Hot Fuzz one. They've got a whole bunch of different forms of editions. You have your big box, which comes with two different steelbook editions. Say this Hot Fuzz one here, which comes with a regular slipcover version and this lenticular version. Both of them have their own unique designs with unique backings that match. Really nice overall. Lenticular only on the front in this case. And it comes with a glossy steelbook with a beautiful emboss deboss job, which whenever it slips out, I will show you. Oh my god. Their steelbooks usually range, so they do have a little paper that comes with it, which usually sticks on the back of the actual box itself. I tend to cut them up or, more professionally, fold them, but I think that's more of a disgrace in its own right. You have your steelbook, which is always the same for both versions, so no matter where you go, you will always get the same steelbook, which is really cool. To some, this is a bit ridiculous, given it's like, so you get two different cases, but you get the exact same steelbook. Yes, I can see why that could be potentially a bad thing. It does come with a credit card kind of deal, which does obviously tell you the edition number, this one being number 1169 of 1770. They usually have more editions of the standard release and then less of the big box release. The big box obviously coming with both separate editions. I'm more of the kind of person who will be like, I'd love to collect both editions, but I'm not going to. And it also comes with an envelope that is also very nicely pressed. That would usually come with a selection of images from the films, usually a postcard or two from the film. Plus, well, like postcard-shaped images, plus like up to 8 kind of character cards, which mostly just show off the main actors and what their names are according to the film, yada yada yada. Their other releases, much like the Shaun of the Dead one, are the same, just slipcover editions with a steelbook on the inside, which this one's actually more of a, it's not as glossy, which is nice, still a unique enough design and all that. They then follow it up with sometimes a really big set. I believe these are called the blue box editions. You can even get protectors for them because they're quite big, but they're also very immersive sets. So I'll show off the Hopefully the Scott Pilgrim, no, sorry, Shaun of the Dead version up there, which I will eventually be getting. They come with a whole bonus lot of stuff. They're usually around, like, I think £60, 50 to £60, because it's a British company. Most of their releases are usually around the same price, maybe $10 lesser if you're getting, like, just the standalone cases. You can get the steelbooks by themselves as well if you just want that. Obviously a cheaper option, assuming they haven't all sold out. I was lucky to get Hot Fuzz on sale. I think I got Shaun of the Dead just on the website normally. And The World's End I got only because they had a restock, because they just found a bunch more stock, and they're like, hey, shit, here you go. And I was like, cool, I'll grab one of those, why not? You know, completes my trilogy, that's all good for me. I already had Scott Pilgrim, because I got that secondhand from, like, a marketplace, you know, festive marketplace kind of jazz. So these do become pricey collectibles to some degree, but because they are limited numbers, of course. Those more obvious sets being limited to like 2,500 units that are like split halfway between the slipcover and the lenticular cover, plus the ones that go in the big box. But the obvious big box ones, like this one, the Shaun of the Dead one, you get a whole array of stuff. Of course, when you go on the website itself, it does explain pretty much the gist of what you can get. You usually get a big poster. You can get a smaller poster that comes with a stand. You get the character cards. You get the steelbook, which in this case is actually new artwork for this particular version. It's also the 4K UHD, so you usually get the best version of the film that you can get. The box is unique artwork. Everything about it is unique artwork all around, and it is exceptional stuff. You always get a card detailing what limited number it is, which is always fun for a lot of collectors when it's like, oh, it's number 1 or 2 or 3, or it's number 850, which is, say, if that's a total amount, that's still kind of cool. So they do have these various degrees of sets that they release every couple of months, which is really cool. They recently did Get Out. I think they've done a whole number of them. They've done, like, King Kong, a lot of random films, but some of these are very cult-heavy films sometimes, like with cult audiences that guarantee that they're going to sell out to some degree, which is always fun. For the most part, I've had no problem with them shipping to Australia. It is very easy. It takes a few weeks, but when it comes in, it's professionally done. I think in one of my previous videos, I did an unboxing for the Hot Fuzz one, which came wrapped in its plastic, which not just wrapped in plastic. It came in a box that had a bunch, like, what are they even called? Let's just say they had a fuck ton of good protection. It had those little, like, kind of foam nuggets protecting it inside a box, all wrapped up and beautifully done. They know how to make sure that their stuff is delivered across country as effectively as possible. So they're very good with their delivery. They're very good with their sets altogether. And I like that their steelbooks, at least for the more, like, usual sets like I have, it's the same steelbook, but when you do open up, the two sets do come differently to some degree. The steelbooks may be identical, but the cards you get are different. Plus, the slipcovers are different, one being lenticular, one being just glossy and embossed, deboss, all that jazz. And the inside, the envelope you get, can come with different character cards and different shots. So if you care enough about that kind of stuff, you do get enough differentiation, so you get enough quality for both if you choose to get both separately but together, you know. So it's like, oh, I want to get the slipcover and I want to get the lenticular, but I don't want to get the big box that it comes with, even though that just is a wrap-up box that just wraps them both together. Which I've heard and seen in other videos that those are quite quality boxes as well, with some beautiful designs to them, especially, in my opinion, the Hot Fuzz one. So those ones can be particularly fantastic. Overall, I'd say Everything Blue is a really worthwhile site to go for if you're looking for premium, like, good quality steel cases and sets as an overall. It comes with your regular kind of stuff. You've got your steelbook, you've got your cool cover, you've got your credit card. I call it a credit card because I think that's what most people refer it to. It's just your card that's pretty much credit card shaped. And it comes with a bunch of images from the film, just printed on little cardboard pieces, of course. Two being the postcard copies and a bunch of character cards as well. They don't come with any booklets or anything more in-depth like that. This is more of a show for show sake, not for reading sake. It's not for, well, it's not for, it's like, unlike stuff like HD Zeta or Film Arena, where you can get stuff that like really emphasizes books that show off behind the scenes stuff or whatever detail it wants to show off, it doesn't have that. It doesn't go that far, so it's not as expensive for that reason. But their sets, especially their really big sets, can be just amazing with the amount of quantity you get from one set. So as an overall, I would highly recommend them. I will hopefully put a link down to their actual website in the description if you want to check out their stuff or the stuff they have released in the past if you want to hunt that down on secondary markets. But yeah, for the most part, I would wholeheartedly suggest Everything Blue. I don't have star ratings for these companies. I did Titans of Cult previously, though that's not a premium brand. It is still a steelbook brand, which is more or less what I'm trying to review. So yeah, I've also done a What Is series for Criterion Arrow Video and Eureka Cinema and like all of those more premium labels of releasing brands, if that makes sense. Like, they do premium releases of the film, but not of the, like, packaging. So this, I'm doing a bit of an opposite effect as to what we're actually showing off. So, yeah, these ones are more mantelpiece items, the ones that you would show off to your mates as, hey, look at how cool this slipcover is, or this lenticular. My preference, slipcovers over lenticulars, because lenticulars can scratch really easily and you want to have them in a protector almost the minute that you get it in. It's a cool effect when you can put it on a table and you can look at it from a distance, go around like, oh look, they're following me, especially the Hot Fuzz one. They're literally pointing shotguns at you. It's fun. But they can damage easily and scratch easily and it's not fun. So the Everything Blue ones, I've had no trouble with their lenticulars so far, which is obviously a good thing. Same as this, their steel cases had absolutely no issues so far. But as we dive into this series, I will be showing off HDZ to Film Arena. I think there's another one there, but I can't remember what it's called. I got a few other premium brands that I plan to show off. I don't have all of them, unfortunately, as much as I'd love to. I can't afford it half the time because they're really bloody expensive. So I do actually have a playlist of my premium films. So if you want to just look at what these sets, particular sets have, like I've got my Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, all of these sets, the Everything Blue ones, I've got links to them. They'll be in the playlist up on the screen and in the playlist description down below, as well as links to the actual individual ones from Everything Blue. But yeah, so I will be doing videos in the future of all of those. So stay tuned for those, and I'll see you next time on Telecreations. Adios.